Hello everyone, welcome to the channel. Today we had a viewer request asking about how would you go about tuning your magazine for the VR series shotgun. And that applies to VR60, 80, 82, but it also applies to any AR platform type of mag-fed shotgun. So we're gonna do that. Please like, share, and subscribe. Leave me a comment. And I'll be able to respond back to you. But first and foremost, we've got it clear. The main thing you want to look at, and that is the how the mag will fit into the mag well. So first off, we want to make sure that we have a mag that is drop free, okay? And that's important because there shouldn't be any kind of binding on the mag body itself when you insert it into the mag well. And some of that is because these are stamped metal mags. So the dimensions are gonna be varied. You know, it's a stamped welded. So you're gonna have some variance in there. So the first thing we wanna do is make sure that it fits and there's no binding and that there's, you know, not very much wiggle. But when we go to release the mag, it should fall, okay? So by doing so, if your mag does not fit the into your shotgun, whichever one you have, is we got to find out if the front and back is it too I guess long in a sense that it's the back is rubbing against the mag well in the front. So if that is the case, then what you have to do is you have to squeeze the front and back of where the mag well is, okay, that inserts in, so that you have clearance front and back. Now, if it is touching the side, then we've got to make sure we squeeze the side to make sure that that fit. Now, you don't want to squeeze so much that you deform the mag and basically ruin it. So it's important that we do a little at a time. A little bit goes a long way, okay? So if you have issue with it basically having double feed or any kind of issue that causes for extraction, ejection, loading, then the thing I would want you to look at is the bolt where it rides back. Now, when the mag is inserted, it's gonna protrude up over the lower receiver. And the upper receiver has the bolt and the carrier and the action itself in there. So all that's moving back and forth. With the protrusion of the mag in there, that bolt carrier and guide could potentially touch the side of the mag, okay? So if it's flared out so much that it's touching, then what you're gonna have to do have is that when the bolt is moving backwards or forward, it's gonna be dragging on it. And the friction is gonna slow that bolt down. And then that's gonna introduce you to have malfunction. So what we wanna look at, and I'm gonna separate this out. Okay, and when you separate, don't rotate it like an AR. Separate it out and let it fall out, okay? Because your feed lip here, if you rotate it, you're gonna ruin that part because it's gonna be riding up against the bolt in here. So don't rotate the low receiver like an AR 15 because then you'll ruin this part. But what's gonna happen is as you load the mag, notice the protrusion up in here, okay? That's the area that the bolt and the bolt carrier rides against on the inside of the receiver, okay? If that area, if that carrier part touches this, the bolt's gonna slow down. It's gonna slow down when it's on the ejection, and it's gonna slow down when it's on the feed. So that's gonna cause some problem. If that bolt does not freely move forward, you're gonna have issue with the round had already come out, and then now you've got one that's pointing straight up as the bolt's moving across it to strip a shell off, okay? So it's important that we first make sure that that is not happening. Anything else you do is going to be, you know, counterintuitive to making sure that that bolt moved freely. Now, I've got the gun to shoot, you know, low velocity brass, and it's not a problem because that's the only issue that, if that's the only issue, you should be able to shoot down to 1150, no problem, okay? Now, the other issue that we're going to talk about is tuning the mag itself internally and any part that is burr marks and stuff like that. So we'll get into that. We'll go ahead and disassemble. So the follower normally it would have a last round bolt hold open because it needs to move freely in here with very little friction. That's one of the recommendations. Go ahead and remove that. You'll lose out on last round hold open, but I rather have reliability than that one feature, which normally as I shoot competitively, that's not important to me. As far as the actual bolt hole, okay? But if you like that feature, understand that you have to do some other things to make sure that feature and everything else is minimize your friction that when the follower moves up on the mag body, that it doesn't restrict it or slow it down so that the bolt will catch the shell at the right time. Next, we want to address the follower. Because it is a molded piece, sometimes you'll have some areas on here like this little nub. You want to be able to make sure that area is smooth or at least filed down, and that way it moves across the mag body and not have any where it would drag against it. You want it to be able to have smoothness, so you would go ahead and file that down. It don't have to be like a polishing job on there. It just makes sure that those areas are filed down. So again, that's the follower. The other thing is that being that this is stamped metal, there's going to be variance in how it's shaped and where it's at and what how it fits inside your mag itself. Inside your magwell itself. So one other thing that I go over is the mag catch. Inside the mag catch where the opening is and it's stamped out, I take a file and in the corner of the mag catch opening, I sand or file down the corners, each of the corners of the opening, okay? And that's on the inside because again, the follower is going to go in there, and the spring, the follower normally would not touch or come close to it, but the spring being that it's compressed, it will move wherever it needs to move. And if there's a area that it can catch on, then you might have some issue with your mag. So I would file not the outside, but the inside corner of each of these mags. There's one there, and then on the opposite, and then top. On top, okay, and you want to make sure you're not going to take any material out of the opening here, just the inside corner. So if you can get in there and knock the sharp edges down, perfect. Okay, the second part is the back corner here. You want to make sure that is not sticking up to where potentially the bolt comes across it, and then the center part, okay, the center part here, the same thing. And then the front leading edge of your mag, you want to hit that part to make sure you round that out, because as the follower hits it and as you put pressure on it, it's going to want to rotate it down, and if there's any snag there, it's going to catch into the front part of that follower. So you want to clean that part off, okay? And then again, the back part, if you do decide to take the last round bolt hold open out, then this area here needs to be cleaned up. And you want to go ahead and run a file across there and inside here to make sure you knock out all the sharp edges, okay, in that sense. So again, doing that. Now, one of the thing that comes up is, okay, so I'm shooting lower velocity shells. So what happened? Well, if you got a spring that is over tension, then what's happening is that as the bolt moves back on the high velocity, it's going to come back quick. It's going to come back, you know, it's going to recoil and then come back in the battery quick. So if you don't have a spring that allows for to push the next shell up as quick as the bolt comes back, that bolt's going to overrun the shell. So by the time that the bolt comes back, if you don't have enough upward pressure on the spring load, then the bolt's going to close before the next shell comes up, and you're going to miss a chambering around, okay, a shell. So you have to balance the spring rate on the follower and the shell, the next shell that's come up. So if you're running a lower velocity, okay, if you're running a lower velocity and there's that upward pressure on that spring, then this bolt here, when it comes into contact, even though the shell comes up first and get there before the bolt has a chance to come back, now you've got all that spring pressure load on top of that shell. And with the lower movement of this bolt, it's going to want to ride and push that shell into to chamber it. Well, the bottom of the next shell is going to have a pressure up on it, and it's going to slow that bolt down, and you will not have a bolt that's, you know, smooth across. So you have to balance that with the mag spring weight on that. So in order to do that, you got to make sure that the rate of your spring is, you know, matches the power of that bolt coming back. So what you need to do is if, you know, you can decide if you want to test it or not. Some of the results that you get are going to be different because, again, every single one is different. So you got to make sure. So take it slow. Again, on my 5-rounder, on my 10-rounders, and on my 9-20-rounder, I'm tuning the spring according to this particular rifle. Okay, it's going to be different for every single one. So don't take what I do and apply it to you. You have to step it up at each level and not. So unlike on this one, I've cut the spring down to where it works. I've done it slowly, tested, make sure that it runs and that, you know, it still has enough pressure to load the next round while the bolt is coming back forward. So again, these are tuned to this particular shotgun. Same thing with my 10 rounder. This is not, as you guys probably know, if you start loading a 10 rounder or a 19 rounder, as you get down to about, you know, 5 or 6 or 7, you're gonna have a hard time loading it, okay? So this also, the spring has been tuned to it, cut, so that we have a very good loading on the follower, but not enough to where if I'm shooting a 1180 or 1200, that this follower is gonna slow that bolt enough to where it won't chamber around. Okay, so that's something to think about. Now the question is, well, one of the things we see a lot is the round getting rim locked. That's meaning the top part of the top shell sitting on top, the rim is sitting behind the one below it. And if that happens, then your bolt is just gonna lock across it. It won't strip the round off. I've not had any problem with rim locking on that, but the issue is a lot of shooters are seeing a lot of that happening. Well, in my thinking, I don't have that because I've tuned my spring to the mag and allow for there's not any additional bouncing in there as the bolt comes back or forth. It's not causing any kind of a bounce, or if there's any drag inside the magazine itself, that it causes this to have a shell that's loose instead of having just sitting on top, stacked on top of each other. So again, make sure that as you are tuning these, you make those changes accordingly. And that comes in the rate, the spring rate itself, okay? Same thing with the 19 rounder. Again, very, very easy to load. I have not had any issue loading it all the way to capacity. Same thing with the five rounder. So those things are something that you have to work on. And again, I've cut the spring to each of these, but it could be, you know, one coil, two coil, three coil from each of these spring. So you have to try to find what is going to run best for your situation. Okay. But the main thing here is front to back, side to side, making sure that these things clear. First of all, that it fits into the magwell. Okay. It fits in the magwell, and this, the top part of this, anywhere along those two sides, okay, these two sides, if the bolt carrier in here, if any of that, I don't know if I can show you, but if this part here is making contact, if this part here is making contact against the feed lips or the back part of that magazine, this pack part here or along here, then you're going to slow that bolt down, and you're going to have some feeding, ejection, and extraction issue. So that's the first thing you need to do, is to make sure that there's no contact and that bolt goes back and forth very smooth. And I'm going to show you that here. Again, empty. So with the mag in, this bolt should move back and forward. And I'm just holding it with it. It should not be here and stuck and then stuck. It should be moving back and forth freely. So if your bolt and your magazine inserted, if it does not move back and forth freely, then we first need to address that. Now again, I've taken the last round bolt hole open out. So if you try to do this with that in, it's gonna lock the bolt back. So in this situation, I would take that out just to make sure to test. But if you wanna use it again, put it back. The main thing is I wanna eliminate as much drag and friction as I can throughout the whole shotgun. Not just the bolt, not just the mag. I wanna take out any kind of friction that could potentially cause any kind of loading issue. So I took that out, but the bolt should move back and forth freely. There should be no hang up. The only part that you might feel a little resistance is when the bolt ride over the hammer and then back. Okay. But other than that, there should be no hang up. Okay. And if there is, I would address that issue with the mag body, dragging the carrier, dragging across the mag body. Okay, this part right here on both sides. If that's the case, then you need to address that, okay, first. And that's, you can do so by, again, squeezing this area. If it's too spread out, you squeeze that area. If front and back is too tight in that magwell, then we need to squeeze this area. This, we do not want to squeeze anywhere below where it inserts into the magwell, okay? We don't want to mess down here. It doesn't matter down here. It's only up here that we need to make sure that it fits. Okay. Again, very straightforward as far as where to sand and file. Again, the four corners of your mag catch, the back of your last round bolt open inside of that. Okay. The top of your mag, and then the curved side of this. Making sure that is clear and nothing is gonna potentially ride across it. The bolt can ride across it and snag that. And then last but not least, the front of the mag where the cutout is, because the follow will tend to tilt forward and drag on it. We want that to be as radius that out so that there's no sharp edge to where this can bind up. Okay. Okay. Again. Going to be able to make it a transition between it moving, loading, and when you're the bolt catching the shell. Okay. If you have any additional question, please leave me a comment and I'll try to answer it for you. Otherwise, please like, share, and subscribe. It helps to build the channel. Thank you for watching.